What did you say?
You heard me.
I didn't understand what you said.
You understand me perfectly.
Don't pretend.
It won't work with me.
Is he senile, as well as hard of hearing?
I should have said... Why did you say what you said?
Because it's true, and you need to hear the truth before
you die.
You think you can scare an old man like me? You can't, you know. I've already seen hell. It doesn't scare me, neither does death.
I'm not trying to scare you.
What then?
I'm merely trying to prepare you for the inevitable. That's what he told his victims.
They probably didn't believe him either.
What victims?
I told you, don't pretend. You may lie to anyone else, but you
can't lie to us.
We won't allow it.
Allow it? Allow it? Who are you to allow anything? To scare me after all.
No, that's not our purpose.
What then? I am an old man. I don't have the patience for these kind of games. Get to your point.
Why? Are you going somewhere?
I'm going to hell, according to you. My churches, my trinkets, they are the only things I will regret leaving when I die.
A thief and his spoils.
Sickening.
Regard for their history?
That's rich.
Precious mementos, ripped from the arms of their owners, sobbing and crying for their return. Just as the owners were then torn from the arms of their loved ones. What kind of history is that?
History of the condemned,
I'd call it.
These trinkets were collected at a very great risk to myself. I had them removed from Germany and sent to safety on my brother's U-boat. I rescued them. And besides, the owners were all going to die anyways. What could I do? Loser, is it? I was successful before the war, you know. I had my own business, employees. I made lots of money.
Squandered it, I expect. On things, probably.
Possessions.
Or a lavish lifestyle.
I was young, foolish. What do you think?
Wine.
Women.
And song. An age-old temptation.
What if I did? So did many others.
Many others? Help those less fortunate, those singled out for hatred or oppression.
Bah! That's a lie. Show me a rich man, and I'll show you somebody only out for himself. That's why they're rich in the first place.
And of course, you've been living hand to mouth since the war.
I do all right.
Besides, once the war started, all that was over with.
Wasn't it?
No more parties. No more lavish meals.
Yes. We had little time for parties and such nonsense once we came to power. Too much else to do.
Wholesale murder of a people for one.
Well, that was a lot of it.
Look, he's still proud of it.
Proud? I don't know if that's the right word. It was an accomplishment.
To be counted among his life's best works.
No, no, you don't understand. The country was in complete disarray since the First Great War. Unemployment was high, the economy was shattered, the people were demoralized. They needed a unifying symbol, a banner to rally.
A tool, then?
A political expediency?
Exactly. A common enemy, or enemies, I should say, since it wasn't only the Jews. Poles, gypsies, Russians, homosexuals even, anyone different, it's the same today.
So we've learned nothing? Humans have made no progress since those days?
What progress? Look at Rwanda, or Croatia. Slaughters of one's enemies still goes on today. Minorities are targets for brutal murders. What's changed? If you remember nothing else, remember this. Man is a predator. Always was, always will be. Killing is as natural to a man as it is to a wolf, or a bear, or any other creature of the wild.
Civilization counts for nothing.
Civilization is a veneer that comes peeling off when man is conflicted with hard choices. Survival, hunger, violence. It's not very deep. We did experiments, you know. Mothers forced to choose between children and spouses. Fathers between sons and mothers. You'd be amazed.
We know. We were there.
Well, so was I. Doesn't mean we learned the same lessons.
Well, what lessons did you learn?
Nah, too many to list. Wouldn't want to bore you.
The last thing you are is boring.
True evil seldom is.
I'm not evil. I just lived in an evil time. Evil deeds were acquired. If not, you'd find yourself in trouble. Or dead.
Better you than them.
No, not quite. Better that they died than me.
Why?
What do you mean by? Because it was better.
Better for you?
Better for everyone. They had no chance. No hope.
You saw to that?
No. They saw to that when they surrendered without a fight. Cattle. Going to the slaughter. What good are people like that? Darwin had it right. Survival of the fittest.
Survival of the strongest, you mean?
Whatever. Nature rewards the strong. Only the toughest can prevail.
So anything weaker, anything different, deserves to be annihilated?
Well, if they can't adapt, if they can't learn from past experiences, why not?
And who decides?
Who decides what? Who's to go, who's to stay? The strong, of course. Only the toughest can prevail.
Life is too precious to waste on the weak.
Well, I don't know if I'd say it like that. Let's just say that the battle goes to the best soldier.
Interesting analogy for someone who lost the war.
Ah, but we were winning until the Americans got involved. Them and their cursed technology. Planes, tanks, bombs, by the cross. We were inundated.
They were only stronger because of the weapons?
Well, mostly. Of course, Hitler made a fatal error in opening up a war on two fronts. Between the Russians and the Americans, we didn't stand a chance.
Hitler was weak then.
Hitler was crazy, at the end. And weak, yes. He thought we were invincible.
But before that, he was right, justified in trying to build an empire based on racial hatred and genocide?
If Hitler had accomplished all his goals, he would have begun a thousand year life. Look at Rome. Look at Alexander. Look at Genghis Khan. You don't establish empires or dominate the world by worrying about human rights. You do it by killing off all who oppose you.
Extraordinary.
It would have been. Truly.
No. I meant your capacity for self-rationalization.
What?
He doesn't see it.
See what?
I agree. Total lack of remorse.
Remorse for what? Killing in wartime?
You feel no distress at the tens of thousands you sent to die because they were weak and defenseless. Yet you can spout excuse after excuse for why your beloved leader was justified in sending an entire country down the path to destruction.
Look, you have to understand. Death was unavoidable in those days.
It still is, as far as I know.
No, it was either them or me. I told you that. If I hadn't done what they told me to do, I would have been killed.
Another old excuse heard too often. I was just following orders.
I was. And if I hadn't, I would have been shot. And another would have taken my place. And another. What would the point have been? I couldn't stop it.
True change starts with only one voice.
What could you have done if your voice had been joined by others?
But no one was protesting. We all went along.
Our point exactly.
Talk about expediency. He boasts of belonging to the stronger species, then whines because he wasn't able to stand up and protest what he knew was wrong.
I didn't mind. Believe what you like. You'd have to be there to understand.
But we were.
We already told you that.
If you're there, then prove it. Tell me something only someone who's there would know.
We can tell you what you were thinking at almost any given moment.
How? Were you inside my mind?
What do you think?
Look inside.
You'll find us there.
You still try to scare me, eh? Put the fear of God in me.
To fear God, you have to believe in him in the first place. Otherwise, there's nothing to fear.
I believe.
Do you? Or is it just another bargain you made? I'll believe in God if you don't
send me to hell.
God doesn't bargain like that.
You should know.
What do you mean?
All those people you sent to their death. Crying and beseeching their God to save them.
Save them.
He didn't. Did he?
No. You're right about that.
Do you think God cares about death?
He must. It's as plentiful as rain. He must like it.
Are you defining God or the Nazis? Didn't you act like gods?
Yes. I take your point. We did, didn't we? We had the power of life and death over our enemies.
You reveled in it. You enjoyed it.
What human doesn't? We all have power of one sort or another.
Not all.
Some are content to stand back. Let others wield the power, as you call it.
Who? Show me such a person. They don't exist.
They do.
Dreamers.
Artists.
Poets.
Fools, weaklings, sorted idiots, one and all.
They have no place in society?
Oh, they have a place in society. Just not in the upper crust. Not with the brave who carve out a world from the raw world.
But don't the strong, the brave, have a duty to defend the weaker members? The sculptors, the painters, the writers who record the history?
A duty? No. The strong have a duty to hold their civilization against those who would take it.
But what kind of civilization would you have without the artist? What kind of culture is created by warriors running around warring on each other? A warrior society concerned only with the laws of the jungle. Do warriors create beautiful temples in which to worship? Or a painting that can make your breath stop? Or a piece of music that floods your heart with tears?
That brings up another question.
Why keep the tchotchkes?
What?
If artists, like painters and poets and sculptors, are weaklings and fools, why keep the things they created?
Why? Because they're treasures.
Treasures conveys some sort of intrinsic value. How can something that was created by soft-headed idiots have value?
Look, the tchotchkes might be the only records that the people are here. Humans are fragile, yes? Easily broken. The people who own these things are dead now.
Just as you will be soon.
Just as I will be soon. Death means nothing. Less than nothing. During the war, we all saw too much of it. Bodies stacked up like cordwood. It becomes meaningless. The only way we know our people are here is by what they leave behind. That is their legacy.
And how will we tell you ever existed? What will your legacy be?
The fear and hatred he inspired in his victims. He carries it like a shroud.
I do not. I don't even think of them.
You think about them all the time. In the privacy of your thoughts, they haunt you. get more intrusive every day. Otherwise,
why are we here?
I don't know. I didn't invite you. I can't even see you.
I told you. Senile.
I'm not senile. My doctor says I'm in good health for a man my age.
What they actually say is that you're in good health considering the shape you're in.
Whatever. It's all the same.
It's not even close, but let's not debate it. My point is this. The only legacy you leave behind is one of fear and hatred. Nothing to take pride in. No lasting monument based on hope or love or something constructive. No children to bear your name.
Children. Yes. My wife and I. We always wanted children. But she couldn't. You know.
Talk about natural selection.
What do you mean?
Do you think that was nature's way of telling you? You weren't good enough to reproduce. That she didn't want you in the gene pool.
Well, I never thought of it like that before.
Perhaps you should have.
Yes. But do you know, children are no guarantees that their name will live on. Children can be killed just as easily as the parents. Sometimes even easier. We prove that. Whole families eradicated. Whole towns.
Almost a whole people.
Just so. That's what makes my chances so important. They might be the only record.
Record of what?
I told you. Records that the people are here. That they existed.
And who keeps the record?
Like, those who come after, of course.
But if warriors are all that's left, who would care for the Tchotchkes?
In your warrior society, there's no room for those who record history, remember? No painters, no poets, no writers.
So what you are saying is that the weaker members do have a place in society. That without them, all we have is war and warriors.
And why would warriors treasure your tchotchkes? They aren't weapons of war. They aren't of value to a soldier. They'll be thrown out like the trash they are.
They are trash! They're my little tchotchkes!
They'll go to someone who won't appreciate them.
Over my dead body!
That's the general idea.
Who do you think you are? You just come here to trouble an old man. You're not even real.
We're as real as your thoughts.
Your dreams.
Your hopes. Your fears.
You know, I never before realized.
Hello? Are you alone, old man? Are you alone, old man?
Yes. Who are you?
Never mind who I am. I heard voices. Who is here with you?
You hear voices? I hear voices. Does that mean both of us are crazy?
No.
You are free to look around. We are quite alone. Or at least, I think we are alone.
You don't have a TV? Maybe that's what I heard.
No, I don't own one. There are the peddlers of evil in today's world.
Who are TVs?
Those who program them.
That's crazy, man. TV's just TV.
You are a crook?
Yeah.
What are you here for?
What do you mean? I just said I was a crook.
Yes, yes, I know. But specifically, what are you here to steal?
Oh, well, whatever will sell. Anything that you've got that's of value. I'm not particular. Anything that will sell.
Anything that will sell. You are a drug addict, then.
I do drugs. You?
No. I never felt the need. Alcohol sometimes. Nicotine. But nothing more. Never hard drugs.
Well, too bad. You should try some.
No thanks. I find reality difficult enough to deal with without the mind-numbing effects of narcotics.
They don't numb your mind, dude. They liberate it.
I can see where you might think so. What made you pick my house?
What, to rob?
Yes. Is it because an old man lives here, defenseless and unprotected?
No, not just that. Word around town is that you have millions in buried gold around here somewhere. I thought I'd try my luck at finding it.
Millions, is it? My poor deluded boy. If I had millions in buried gold, why would I be living in such a place as this? I'd have a country estate in the south of France.
You mean it's not true?
Oh, I will not deny a tchotchkes, but not millions in buried gold.
What are tchotchkes?
Trinkets, keepsakes, treasures.
Yeah, see, old man, I knew you had to have something of value around here. Look here, gold bars.
Ingots, yes. It was an interesting history. Would you like to hear it?
Yeah, I guess. Whatever.
The gold in those ingots were collected from prisoners in the death camps. I assume you know what the death camp was.
Sure, the Nazi camps in World War II. But what do you think, I'm stupid?
No, not at all. I'm just not sure what schools these days are teaching to our young people. Histories undergo such revision. Academics might have decided that World War II isn't relevant.
No, they still teach it. At least when I was in school, they did. I thought it was interesting.
You found it interesting, did you?
Yeah, Hitler had the right idea about killing the Jews.
Why?
Well, because they were Jews. He knew who his enemy was and he went after them.
And why do you suppose they were his enemy?
Well, you don't know?
Of course I know. I was there. I lived through it. I just want to hear your version of it.
Well, because they were different. They were the root of all evil. They screwed the country up. They screwed up the racial purity of the Germans. All of that.
All of that. And so the torch is passed on to a new generation.
That's right, old man. We can carry on the work you started.
That's what I'm afraid of.
What?
Nothing. They were right. A society built on unsinking barriers is really no society at all.
Who was right?
It's not important. Listen. What I started to tell you about was the golden ingots. How they were collected from prisoners in the death camps.
So?
So nothing. It's just that if you plan on stealing them, you might as well know where they came from. Most of it was jewelry, of course. Pins, necklaces. Taken from the prisoners and melted down. Other parts of it, naturally, were gold teeth, removed from the victims. Some living, some dead. And added to the accumulation. When we had enough, we melted it down and forged the ingots you'll now see before you.
Cool.
Not a word I might have chosen to describe it. But little matter.
How much is that?
Several hundred pounds is worth, I should imagine. I've spent quite a lot of it over the years. The never-ending necessities of life, you know.
Yeah, I know.
Of course, there are other valuables here as well. Fine paintings by masters, silver plate, and other military memorabilia. You might get a nice price for the lot.
I'm gonna keep some of these pictures, if you don't mind.
I don't mind. Which ones interest you?
This, of people getting off the train. And this, of the people in lines, working, carrying bodies.
Yes, I thought you might like those. There's a last vestige of a grand experiment that ultimately was a failure.
A failure?
A resounding failure. Only, I never realized it until...
When?
Quite recently, actually. Quite recently. There are a couple other things you might want to know about my tchotchkes before you take them.
What's that?
Well, it said that the tchotchkes bearers them the spirits of their previous owners, wherever they go.
Spirits? You mean like they're haunted?
I don't know if haunted is the right word to use. Some might say so. Others merely feel it is the conscience of the former owners. Or maybe it's more correct to say it's the conscience of the current owner. Whatever is the case, it's bothersome.
Bothersome? How?
Well, the older you get, the longer it seems to try to hold on to things dear in your life. Friendships, memories. Old people are stubborn, boy. Don't like to turn loose of anything. Money, ideas.
What's that got to do with anything?
Don't be so impatient. I'm trying to explain. We get set in our ways. Don't like to see things change. We've seen too much change in our lives. We're sick of it.
So?
So, the spirits, or haunts, or consciences, or whatever they are, force us to look at things we've held sacred, really, in a different light.
Different? How?
Questioning the truth, the validity of the things you once thought were true. And let me tell you, it's a sad day when you find out that, in the grand scheme of things, you weren't as smart as you thought you were.
I don't understand.
I know. But you will.
What do you... What's that?
A weapon. I'm protecting my property. What does it look like?
Don't do this, old man.
I have to do it, boy. Don't you see? You're walking here like some uncouth savage, expecting no resistance, just rewards for your thievery. But I'm not quite as helpless as you imagined.
I don't want to have to kill you, old man, but I will if I have to.
I think you'll have to anyways. Besides, I couldn't let you just walk in here and take my tchotchkes. They need to be with somebody who can appreciate them, not someone so clearly inferior.
What are you talking about? We're the same, you and I. Exactly the same.
Don't flatter yourself. At least when I was your age, I had enough intelligence to make an informed choice about what I was doing, whether it was right or wrong, and live with that decision. You, on the other hand, are a mindless follower, reacting to outside stimuli such as what is cool.
I'm not like that.
You are. And I'm sorry to deflate your sizable ego, but existence like that is sheer stupidity.
You're saying I'm stupid?
That's exactly what I'm saying. And if your mind wasn't overtaken by the drugs in your system, you might have realized it sooner. Remember when you first came in, you thought you heard voices.
Yeah.
You did.
I wouldn't take those if I were you.
Who's there? What do you want?
You should listen.
Who? The old man? He's dead.
He wouldn't listen either. At least, not until it was
too late.
Too late for what? Where are you?
We're here.
We'll always be here. This one is too stupid to learn. The old man took an extraordinary amount of time to figure it out, but at least he had some intelligence.
Learn what? I didn't have anything to do with that.
Anyone who aligned themselves with their murderers will be equally tainted.
I'm not aligning myself with them.
How quick he is to deny it.
Just moments ago, he was only too eager to proclaim his unity with the old man.
How did you know that?
I told you.
We were here.
We've always been.
Where?
With the tchotchkes. If you take them, we'll be with you.
Until the end.
The end? You mean until I die?
Or go insane, whichever comes first.
We don't care.
But I can't leave them. It's what I came for. It's what the old man died protecting.
Then we look forward to a long and
disturbing association
with you. It's all the same to us.
This is crazy. crazy, some trick of the old man's. You're not real.
We're as real as we need to be.
You'll see.
No, I won't. I don't know who you are or why you're doing this, but I'm not staying around to find out the answer. You can't follow me.
We can follow you.
And we will.
We are the Tchotchkes.
We will never forgive.
And we will never forgive.